Hey guys, Thunder E here, and welcome to my 30-day review of this guy, the LG G7 ThinQ. Now, this is of course the latest smartphone from LG, or at least one of the latest. There's also the V35, but this is the big one, or their big flagship for the first half of this year. Now, the G7 ThinQ, I've been using it for about 30 plus days or so, and this is going to give you a good idea of how I've used this device for quite a bit of time. LG here has done a couple of things with this device. The first thing, of course, is the naming, ThinQ. It's something that I just don't like. I don't think that branding works well with this device because this is a really solid device, and it just, you know, to me, I just don't see where the mix comes in. But from my day-to-day use, I've really liked using the G7 here. Now, the G7 from LG is a solid device. You've got a lot of things. Now, the rear cameras are dual 60-megapixel camera. One is a wide-angle lens. And LG has been doing the wide-angle lens for a while. And it's much better. They've improved the image quality of that. The cameras are really solid, and you can play around with a bunch of features. Of course, you do have those manual modes where you can play around with your audio settings for video. You can play around with the manual settings, which they've done quite well as also on photos. But they do have a new AI mode since everyone's in the AI game, thus the ThinQ monk here. It's nice, I would say, at least from my experience. It's not something I use quite a lot because to me, I don't see the huge benefit from it. It does this really interesting thing where when you hold the camera and you take a photo, or you try and take a photo in AI, it starts trying to guess what's in the scene. Sometimes it mentions things that are just not there, like, you know, it might say pot or roast when you're looking at a human being, but it will still take a nice picture. Daniel has done a cinematic video and gone through some of the features on this camera, so you can definitely check that out to see how well it functions, both the front and the rear camera with this device. And it's a really nice video showing what the G7 ThinQ can do. But if you guys want my buddy Marion Sells to actually do a full video on what a professional photographer thinks, let me know in the comments of this video and we might try to do that for you. So there are a couple of things that this device has that I really like. Now, first off, you guys know I love headphones. There's a lot right behind me. And it's got a quad DAC built in. So that means you're getting probably one of the best audio experiences you ever get on a smartphone. Not just from the headphone jack, but also the speakers. We'll get to that in a second. So having the quad DAC means you're getting some really premium experience, but you also have a headphone jack, which means you don't have to buy anything new. You don't have to spend money on wireless headphones if you don't have those, and you're getting a much more premium experience. But there are also more audio options. There's also DTS X3 3D surround. So when you're gaming, you have your headphones on, you can use that as well, which is pretty nice. Now, this also has, of course, the ability to house, I believe, Dolby Atmos, if I'm not mistaken. Actually, no, I lied, no Dolby Atmos. But you do have, of course, some really nice loud speakers on this device, which is nice. Now, we tested this against a few other devices. This has one of the loudest speakers on the market, hitting almost 118 decibels. Check out that video, it's really fun. You can see how it compares to devices like the Galaxy S9 Plus and the iPhone 10 in terms of how loud this thing can get. But it also has that resonance chamber, so once you lay it on the surface, it actually amplifies the sound, so it makes it really, really loud. And I was quite impressed with what it did, especially with a mono speaker too. This is not a stereo speaker setup on this device. You've got USB Type-C charging. You've got a 3000 milliamp battery, which seems small, but LG's been doing a good job in optimizing battery life of this device, so I haven't had issues with this. This has done a pretty good job lasting me a whole work day. So I can start the day at roughly maybe around like 10 a.m. in the morning. And by, you know, 10, 11 at night, you know, it's probably down to about 30% if I'm just using moderate use. Heavier use, I might have to top it off. But you've got wireless charging as well. You've got all those lifestyle features. So it's mil-spec according to LG, which I'm not sure how mil-spec this is because it's got that glass back and, yeah, you know, whatever they say, but it is still water and dust resistant. So taking this with you, you know, to the beach, especially this summer, makes a lot of sense, especially using the camera and some of those camera functionalities. Now, you've got 6 gigs of RAM, the Snapdragon 845 processor. We all know how good that processor is this year, and they've done a lot of great things with that. So this thing runs really smooth, whether you're using it for a lot of tasks throughout the day or you're gaming, you will get the best advantage of this device. I will say though, while charging, sometimes it runs rather warm. When I say warm, hotter than normal for most phones nowadays. So that's just something I've noticed with that. Fingerprint sensor at the back, that's pretty responsive there. You've got facial recognition, but of course, it's not the high level of security that you expect, but it is still pretty fast and snappy, something you can actually use well on this device. As you can see with my shirt here, it says notch so much. That is something LG has done with this 6.1 inch display. And to me, I don't see why they needed to do that. There was no reasoning. You know, maybe, and some people have talked about bezels and making it thinner and many different things, but to me, I think it just showed that LG was trying to copy and join the fray rather than just sticking to their guns with a device that I think is well built in design. So having the notch to me makes no sense and it requires or brings no benefit to it whatsoever. But that being said though, so you've got an LCD display, it's not an OLED display, which I wish they went with. They say this is one of the brightest displays, it's got a super bright mode. We did a video on that, check that out to see what that actually does for your device. I think overall, this is a solid device through and through. Some of the things LG has done that I don't like, of course, is having the notch right there, and also the name branding, but it's really solid. You've got a great audio experience on here. You've got some really good battery management and battery life. Anything functions really well. Plus, one of the loudest speakers, loudest, on a smartphone that you will find right now currently on the market. So if you have any questions or any comments on the LG G7 ThinQ, let me know. I'll try and answer them for you. Again, if you want Marion Sells to actually do a professional photographer video on this phone, let us know. The more people who actually comment and want that, then of course the chances are we'll probably do that as well. If you're looking to pick up any t-shirts like this one that says notch so much, which means I do not like notch, you can check out our friends at Geek Me Out. I'll have a link for you down below. They sent me a couple of t-shirts to wear. I really like the stuff and it's something you can get. Definitely go ahead and pick up yourself. So don't forget to like and share this video, guys. Favorite this video. Oh, also I have an IGTV channel, so you can check that out as well. Follow us there, download the app, watch the content. We'll put some very different content on there. But this is Thunder E saying thank you very much and always enjoy your entertainment.